For this video, we're describing the relative strengths of acids for our oxoacids. So again, oxoacids are ones made from our polyatomic ions. These acids will obviously contain hydrogen as the acid, our oxygens, and then some central nonmetal atom. We won't be requiring the drawing of Lewis structures, but it is helpful to remind ourselves of the structures of these. So when we refer to nitric acid, we write the formula as HNO3, but it's important to remember that in this structure, the hydrogen is actually bonded to the oxygens. And in fact, that's the case for all oxoacids. So we have to remember that that hydrogen is actually bonded to the oxygens in here, because then we can use that information to determine the trends for strong versus weak acids. The two trends that we're going to look at here are, the first one is where we change the central atom, but have the same number of oxygens on them. So for example, if we compare hypochlorous, hypobromous, and hypoiodous acids, all we're doing is changing the central atom. Realize for these two, these can be rewritten in a different form, more like what we're used to seeing, where the hydrogen is actually next to the central atom. Only when we have a single oxygen do we write these in alternate forms. So you should recognize that HClO is the same thing as HOCl. Common mistake I see, by the way, when we work with HOCl is that students often think that this is a base because of the OH in here, but realize that because this is a non-metal, this cannot act as a base. So it's only if we have a metal with hydroxide that we get a basic solution. Just a quick side note for you on formulas. So for this trend, we are looking at the electronegativity of the central atom. As we get a more electronegative central atom, we will get a stronger acid. And that is because, again, if we think about our structure here, so hydrogen is again bonded to the oxygen. If I have a very electronegative atom, like chloride, it's the most electronegative one in here. What that's doing is it's pulling electrons in the bond between oxygen and chloride toward the chloride, which means that the electrons in between hydrogen and oxygen would also shift that way. It's a slight shift, it's a subtle one, but it means that it's going to weaken this bond between hydrogen and oxygen. Remember, the weaker the bond means the stronger the acid. And so when we are comparing acids where we have different central atoms but the same number of oxygens, we're looking at the electronegativity on our central atom. The more electronegative that central atom, the stronger the acid. In the second trend of oxoacids, now we look at comparisons where we have the same central atom but different numbers of oxygens. And I'm actually going to go to a blank screen on this one to compare. So the ions that are being shown here actually come from the chlorate group. Right, so we have the same central atom in every case, chloride here. All we've done is change the central atom. When we do that, there's two things that happen. One is we are changing the oxidation number of the central atom. So realize in this first one, our oxidation number of chloride is a plus one. The first one was hypochlorous. HClO2 is simply chlorous acid. HClO3 is chloric acid, and HClO4 is perchloric acid. So hypochlorous, chloride has a plus one. In chlorous acid, chloride is a plus three, and it increases by a two count because we're adding that oxygen on every time. So we can use oxidation numbers as one way to justify this. We can also look at the electron density in our anions. So here is our hypochlorite ion, our chlorite ion, chlorate, and perchlorate. And so what's being shown in here is the difference in color based on electron densities. So in the hypochlorite ion, we have a shift of electron density more toward the oxygen. That means that there's a strong affinity for a proton. So this one can readily accept a proton. This one, we get a little bit of that color differentiation where that oxygen still readily wants a proton. So that means that these are relatively strong bases. Because of that color coding and the electron density. Notice once we get to chlorate, ClO3 minus, there's less distinct color differentiation. And so this doesn't necessarily want a hydrogen ion. There's no affinity for the hydrogen ion in chlorate or perchlorate. So these are both weak bases. So we can tell from the strength of the bases that, of course, that means that HClO and HClO2 are weak acids because they have relatively strong bases, and HClO3 and HClO4 would be considered strong acids. They have fairly weak bases. And again, if we go back to our electronegative or our oxidation numbers, same justification as electronegativities. This plus seven is going to draw all of those electron densities in and weaken the bond for H. Same thing in here. That does not happen in HClO2 or HClO. The other patterns that I like to point out are, we already know this differentiation, we just maybe haven't put it together. If I compare nitric versus nitrous acid, there's a break here. Nitric is strong, nitrous is weak. So again, the more oxygens we have, the higher the oxidation number and the change in the strength of the conjugate base. We also see this with sulfuric acid versus sulfurous acid, H2SO3. So we know H2SO4 is a strong acid, H2SO3 is the weak acid. And so the net result is we have two ways to justify why our strong acids are strong here, but the moral of the story is the more oxygens, the stronger an acid. And so that is fair justification if you have to explain why an oxoacid is strong or weak. Great finishing slide for you is to look at these four pairs of molecules, determine which acid in each pair is stronger, and then what trend did you use to identify that. In the slides, I believe I've left the answer. If not, you can come to this one to check it. I'm going to go back here. I'll ask that you pause the slide here to predict your answer and reason. And then when you play the slide again, I will go to the answer. All right, so again, these are the answers you should have come up with for your answers here. And that concludes chapter 14.